Assalamu alaikum students. In the previous lectures, we have studied that a sequence is a function. We also discussed the difference between a sequence function and a regular algebraic function. The difference between a sequence function and a regular algebraic function is that the graphs of regular algebraic functions are continuous curves, since they are defined on real numbers. Whereas the graphs of sequences are not continuous curves. They consist of only discrete points, since sequences are defined on positive integers. Their domain is the set of positive integers or the set of natural numbers. In today's lecture, we are going to study the concept of limit of a sequence, and we will see how the limit of a sequence is different from the limit of a regular function. But before we define the limit of a sequence, let us have a review of the limit of an algebraic function in general. The limit of a function basically shows the behavior of the function as the independent variable approaches a certain value or infinity. So, for example, if we consider the function f of x is equal to 1 over x. Okay. So in this function, as you can see here, as the values of x get bigger and bigger here, this function gets smaller and smaller. Okay. So we can say that as x approaches infinity over here, this function approaches 0. So this thing can be described in the form of a limit as that limit of the function f of x as x approaches infinity 0. So we can also observe this thing from the graph of the function. So if we consider the graph of this function, so the graph of this function f of x equal to 1 over x looks like this. X-axis, y-axis. So this is the graph. Here again you can see that as x approaches positive infinity over here, okay, the height of the graph falls. The graph approaches the x-axis, that is, it approaches 0. Similarly, as x approaches negative infinity over here, so again the graph or function approaches x-axis, so it approaches 0. So here we can also write the limit of this function as x approaches negative infinity is also 0. Similarly, let us consider another function f of x is equal to e to the power x. Now the graph of this function, so it passes through this point 0, 1, so its graph is like this, f of x is equal to e to the power x. So the graph looks like this. So here, as you can see here, so as x approaches positive infinity, the graph goes up forever. It means as x approaches positive infinity, the function approaches infinity as well. So here we can write the limit of this function as x approaches positive infinity is infinity. And as x approaches negative infinity, you can see that function approaches x-axis, that is, it approaches 0. So limit of the function as x approaches negative infinity is 0. Okay. So basically the limit of a function shows the behavior of that function as the independent variable in the function approaches a certain value or infinity. But this is not the formal and precise definition of the limit. The formal and precise definition of limit of a function is epsilon delta definition. Now let us explain what an epsilon delta definition for the limit of a function is. Okay, so let us consider the graph of a function. So this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So let us consider this graph of a function. So this is the graph of a function. So let us consider a point x naught on the x-axis and the corresponding value on the graph will be so this value is the corresponding value to x naught on the graph. So here you can see that as we approach x naught from right or from left, this function approaches this value. So as we approach, so as x approaches x naught from either side, okay, the function approaches this value. So let us call this value as L. So here, as x approaches x naught, okay, the function approaches this value L. So L here is the limit of this function. Okay, now let us describe this thing in the form of epsilon and delta. Okay, so here we consider a small positive real number epsilon on y-axis. Okay, so suppose this distance is epsilon, okay, so this point on the y-axis will be, as you can see here, this is L plus epsilon and this value over here will be L minus epsilon. And similarly, we choose a positive real number delta on x-axis. Okay, so let us choose this distance as delta. So this number is this distance as delta. So this point will be x naught minus delta and this will be x naught plus delta. Okay, now if we draw the lines to connect these y values to their corresponding x values over here, so let us draw the lines. Correspondingly here, okay, so here you can see that we have formed a rectangle over here like this. So this is a rectangle, so here is this delta value, so this is delta. Okay, so as this delta value gets smaller and smaller, so correspondingly this epsilon value also gets smaller. Okay, so in other words, if the distance between x naught and any x in this interval gets smaller and smaller, correspondingly the distance between this L value and the function values also get smaller. Or we can also say that if we squeeze this interval x naught minus delta to x naught plus delta, if we squeeze this interval, correspondingly this interval L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon will also get squeezed. Okay, so this rectangle will squeezed into this point. Okay, so this thing will happen when the distance between any x value in this interval and x naught gets less than this lambda. So here, as the distance between x and x naught is less than lambda, then correspondingly the distance between the function values and L gets less than epsilon. Okay, so this is the formal definition of the limit. So we can write, we write limit of the function f of x as x approaches x naught is equal to L. So what is the precise definition of the limit of a function? So the precise definition of limit of a function, okay, so for a function f of x, okay, so we write that limit of f of x at a point x naught is equal to L if for every epsilon greater than 0 there exists a delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus L is less than epsilon when x minus x naught mod is less than delta. Okay, so the precise definition of the limit of a function states that a function is said to have a limit at a point x naught, okay, if for every small positive real number epsilon there exists a positive small real number delta such that if the distance between x and x naught is less than delta, then the distance between f of x and L is less than epsilon. So this is the formal or precise definition of a function in general. Okay, so now we will define the precise definition of the limit of a sequence. So now the precise definition of limit of a sequence. So let us consider the graph of a sequence. As we discussed previously, that the graph of a sequence lies only in first and fourth quadrants because sequences are defined only for positive integers. So here our x-axis is basically the set of natural numbers, okay. So let us have the graph of sequence, and the graph of sequences, as we have already seen, consists of discrete points. They are not continuous curves. So the graph will be discrete points. So suppose this is the graph. So this is the graph of the sequence. So the sequence is this sequence an. So here as we go along in the positive x-axis, so if we go along the right, here n approaches positive infinity, okay. So here you can see that the graph of this sequence here approaches a certain value. So let's call this value as L, okay. So if we see this value L, here you can see that as the terms of this sequence get bigger and bigger, or as n approaches infinity over here, the sequence values approach this value L over here, okay. So L is a limit of this sequence. So here we choose a positive real number, small positive real number epsilon here. So let us suppose this is epsilon, so this value is epsilon, then this point will become L plus epsilon and this is L minus epsilon. Okay, if you look through the graph carefully, so we will see that here now this distance is epsilon, so this distance is epsilon, and as we go along the graph, this distance gets smaller and smaller, the distance gets less than this epsilon. Okay, so a time will come on the graph when the distance between these sequence values and this L value will be less than this epsilon. So here we can see that, for example, if you see over here, this distance is less than epsilon. For example, this value corresponds to the natural number, suppose n. So here we can see that for all the terms where n is greater than or equal to this value, so this n is greater than or equal to n over here, okay, the distance between the sequence values and this L value is less than epsilon. Then we say that L is the limit of this sequence. So here the sequence an, okay, approaches to this value L as n is greater than or equal to this value. Okay, so we write that limit of this sequence an as n approaches positive infinity or infinity is L if n is greater than or equal to that n. So we also write that, so we also say that the sequence an converges to L. So an converges to this L value. So now this is the precise definition of the limit of a sequence. So what is the precise definition of the limit of a sequence? Okay, so a sequence an is said to converge to a limit L if for every small positive real number epsilon there exists a natural number or positive integer n such that the distance between an and L is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to that natural number. So this is the precise definition of the limit of a sequence. Okay, so a sequence an is said to have a limit L, or it is said to converge to a limit L if for every small positive real number epsilon there exists a natural number n such that the distance between the sequence terms and L, or the distance between an and L, is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to n, as we just discussed over here in this graph. Or we can also say that the sequence an converges to a limit L, okay, if for every epsilon we can find a positive natural number n. So here this natural number n will always be a function of this epsilon, so it will all be expressed in terms of epsilon. So here n is some function of epsilon. So this is very important thing. Okay, so now we will discuss some examples in which we find the limit of given sequences. using this precise definition of the limit of a sequence. So we have first example, show that limit of the sequence n minus 1 over n plus 1 as n approaches infinity is 1. Using the definition of limit. Okay. So we have to prove that the limit of this sequence n minus 1 over n plus 1 is 1 using the precise definition of the limit of a sequence. So here, so let us prove this. So here our sequence an is this sequence n minus 1 over n plus 1, okay, and here L value is 1. So here L is the limit. So we evaluate an minus L mod is less than epsilon, and then we will try to find the positive integer n. So what is an minus L mod? So n minus 1 over n plus 1 minus 1 mod is less than epsilon. So this implies we can write it as n minus 1 minus n minus 1 over n plus 1 mod is less than epsilon. To simplify it further, so we will get minus 2 over n plus 1 mod is less than epsilon. So again, what is this thing? So this will become, so this will imply 2 over n plus 1 is less than epsilon. Okay, now we have to solve for n. Okay, so this implies n plus 1 by 2 is greater than 1 by epsilon. So n plus 1 is greater than 2 by epsilon. So this implies n is greater than 2 by epsilon minus 1. Okay, so if we compare this inequality with n is greater than or equal to n, so this is n. So here n is 2 by epsilon minus 1. Okay, so which is, as you can see, that it is a function of epsilon. Okay, so in this example, okay, we took an minus L mod less than epsilon and we found a positive integer n such that n is greater than or equal to n. Okay, so this shows that the limit of this sequence as n approaches infinity is 1. So this implies limit as n approaches infinity of the sequence an is 1. Okay, so if given a sequence and its limit, and if we evaluate an minus L mod less than epsilon, and if we succeed in finding a natural number n such that n is greater than or equal to n, then it is proved that the limit of that sequence is L. So now let us consider another example. Show that limit n over n minus 1 as n approaches infinity is 1. So again we have to prove or show this limit using the definition of limit. So here this is an and this is L. So we evaluate. So here again an is n over n minus 1, L is 1. So we evaluate an minus L mod is less than epsilon. So this implies n over n minus 1 minus 1 mod is less than epsilon, which implies n minus n plus 1 over n minus 1 mod is less than epsilon, which gives us 1 over n minus 1 mod is less than epsilon, so which implies 1 by n minus 1 is less than epsilon. So we can write it as n minus 1 is greater than 1 by epsilon by taking the reciprocals on both sides. So this implies n is greater than 1 by epsilon plus 1. So again, we succeeded in finding n. So here n is 1 by epsilon plus 1. So hence, limit of this sequence n over n minus 1 as n approaches infinity is equal to 1. Shown. Now I am giving you some questions as an exercise, okay, where you are required to show the given limits of sequences. Do it yourself. Okay, so question 1, so exercise. So question 1 of the exercise is show that the limit of the sequence, limit that the limit of 2n minus 1 over n plus 2 is equal to 2 as n approaches infinity. Now question 2 is show that limit n approaches infinity of the sequence n square plus 2 square root minus n is equal to 0. Okay, so these two questions are left as an exercise for you, and if you face any problem in the solution of these problems, or if you have any questions regarding the limits of sequences, you can discuss all these things in the next class. And the next class is going to be a live class on real analysis, and in that live class, so we will discuss solutions to these problems as well as some other questions on limits of sequences, and we will also complete the topic of the limit of sequences by introducing a very important theorem, which is the uniqueness theorem of the limit of a sequence. That is, the limit of a sequence is always unique. So all these things will be discussed in that live class.